Lord Jesus and become fishers of men, as he put it, the exciting and wonderful things that we can witness.
We'll be happy to tell you all we can about his ministry. Or perhaps you'd rather see it for yourselves.
Said that I could drink and never thirst again. but still he loved me anyway. And he'll do the same for you.
Amen.
If you only ask him to, just trust him and you'll be forever changed. He is waiting for you at the well. He knows where you are and what you will need. Lord, give me a drink of that water.
Amen.
Oh, that living water. Let it flow from me to everlasting life. Oh, I need a taste of that fountain flowing from heaven. I'll leave my
I will. Be not faint. I'm praying. Look at me. I'm totally humble with him.
Say that. Tell no man. Or go that way. Show that something to the priest. And offer the gift of Joseph to make it as a testimony.
It's a miracle. I'm perfectly well again.
I say unto thee, I have not found a stone of faith. No, not today.
You told Jesus what you said.
I know. My servant lives. It's time to be good.
Oh, God, Jesus Christ.
We thought. Young man, I say unto thee, arise.
Make sure that you didn't spend it on something foolish on your way here.
What did you do with it? Did you spend it all?
No. That is my father. My father's been sick for a long time. Definitely sick. We had the money for taxes, but we had to spend it on physician and medicine.
You had no right to do that. That was the government's money.
It'll get paid, sir. We just need more time.
I thought you said he was deathly ill.
He is, sir.
How do you expect to pay your taxes?
I hope he gets some work, sir.
Oh, you'll have some work, no doubt. Do you have any family? Brothers, sisters, uncles?
Yes, sir.
I see. Good then. Nobody will miss you. Guards, take him away.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to find you some work, boy. You'll bring a good price in the slave market. Enough to pay your father's taxes, I see.
Slave market? No, you can't do this.
You stole from the government. Now you should have to pay. Take him away.
No.
Stop that boy.
Thank you. Wasn't Judas upset tonight when you poured that oil on Jesus' feet?
He said that it should have been sold and the money given to the poor. I did it as an act of worship because I love Jesus so much.
I wonder what Jesus meant when he said that he would take the boy for the day of his burial.
He said that the poor we will have with us always, but that we will not have Jesus with us always. Martha, I can't imagine not having Jesus stop in to see us every once in a while.
Of course, we won't have as many people coming by today as Tavia as came by. Although, I think we came more to see Lazarus than Jesus.
Well, Martha, think of it. How many people do you know who have been raised from the dead? If it wasn't for our beloved Jesus, our brother Lazarus would still be in the grave. I'll never forget that day, as long as I live.
To think he'd already been dead for 4 days. I remember telling the Lord that if he'd only been here, Lazarus would have died, would not have died. When the Lord told me that Lazarus would rise again, well, I knew he'd rise again at the resurrection of the last day, but neither of us knew what miracle Jesus would perform that day. True, although I had no doubt that he was the Son of God, the Christ, the Son of God, especially after he said to me, I'm the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, yet though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die.
Oh, Jesus was as heartbroken as we. When Jesus wept, Lazarus' death was, I felt deep, more deep than ever. We've all been so close.
I think out of the three of us, you have been the closest to him, Mary. Oh, I love to serve him and have everything just right when he comes by. But he says, you've chosen the best part by sitting and listening to his words.
How can I not listen? He said that he and God are one. His voice was the voice that spoke creation into being. His words spoken to Moses were his words.
And to think, only a short time ago, he said, Lazarus, come forth. And Lazarus did come forth, grave clothes and all.
What a wonderful day. A lot of our friends believed on Jesus that day. Truly, I'll never forget you.
There's Peter. You remember Peter and Andrew. They were the brothers who also left everything to follow Jesus. Peter, can you come here for a minute?
Of course, James.
These people have just arrived from Jerusalem. We've been telling them all about Jesus and his ministry.
How do you do it?
We were just about to tell them about the Garden of Gethsemane and all the things that happened there afterwards, but...
Well, we thought that probably you'd do a better job of relating the details. Would you mind?
No, of course not.
You'll want to hear what Peter has to say. Goodbye, Peter. Goodbye.
It was so nice to meet you all.
Bye. You'll want to hear what Peter has to say. Of course. Peter always has a lot to say. I usually have too much to say. Forgive me. I was a little hesitant to talk. You see, in order for me to tell you the whole story, I have to be honest, painfully honest. Jesus told us that one day things were going to be a bit more me explain. Up until that time, Jesus' public ministry had gone well. The multitudes loved him. They followed him wherever he went. Sometimes we have to get in our boat just to get away from him. But there were those who didn't love Jesus. In fact, they hated him. They were our own religious leaders. Imagine that. Those who knew the prophecies that the Messiah would be born in Bethlehem, that he would rise up out of the house of Judah and be the greatest prophet this world has never seen. It is so ironic that they of all people should miss the pure truth that the Messiah they preached about was in their very midst. It was jealousy. Simple as that. You see, Jesus had revealed their hypocrisy, how they would appear to be so righteous on the outside, but were so rotten on the inside. Whitest sepulchers, full of dead men's bones, he had put it. It was about 2 days before the feast of the Passover when Jesus announced to us that he would be crucified. Crucified! We couldn't believe what we had heard. As a matter of fact, a few days before, the people lined up the streets and shouted, "Hosanna! Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord." He further astonished us by telling us there'd be one of his own chosen 12 to betray him. One of us. We couldn't imagine who it would be.
His trial must be immediate. He thinks the false witness to charge him with blasphemy and treason since he calls himself the Son of God, a king. It's also important we get the people stirred against him, too.
I'll see to it that he is charged. Okay?
Stop.
I say it first.
It is also important not to hold the trial on Tuesday. And you, Judas Iscariot, you will deliver him as soon as possible to us after the feast.
Yes, yes, sir. What will you give me?
And all you think about is money. How much?
30 pieces of silver. No more, no less.
done. I'll get back in touch with you.
Judy, it shall not go well with you if you fail in your mission.
As we all shared in the horror of one of us delivering Jesus to his enemies, even then, unnoticed by the rest of us, Jesus was telling Judas to do what he had to do quickly. He then proceeded to tell us that all of us would be offended and run away from him in his hour of crisis. I knew I would never do such a thing. I made the mistake of boasting about that to him. I was crushed when he told me that I would not deny him not just once, but three times before the cock crew the next morning. Oh no, not me, Lord, I had said so confidently. Even if I had to die with you, I would never deny him. After we had eaten, Jesus took four of us while he prayed at the Garden of Gethsemane. After he had finished, there a group of soldiers came, led by one of the 12. Judas came right up to Jesus, mockingly hailed the Lord as his master, and betrayed him with a kiss. I was quick to react. I drew out my sword, and I cut off the ear of the high priest's servant. Jesus rebuked me. He said, "Put up thy sword, for he that take up the sword shall perish with the sword. Can I not call unto my Father, and he shall send me 12 legions of angels?" Even then, howbeit it was prophecy should come to pass. Jesus lifted the man's ear and restored it, just as if it had never been severed. The soldiers then bound the hands of Jesus behind him and took him to Annas, who said to Caiaphas, the high priest. Well, Jesus was right. At first, we all forsook him. We all fled. True, I did follow, but I made sure it was at a distance so that no one would associate me with him. I wanted to know what was going on, so I went to the darkest part of Caiaphas' palace where his servants were warming themselves by the fire.
Thank you.
I warned him not to have anything to do with that just man. Poor Pilot. He tried so hard to be strong. He said that he'd washed his hands publicly as a sign that he wanted no part in sentencing this Jesus. He told the crowd that he found this man to be innocent, but yet he gave in to their whims. He had Jesus scourged. And then he released that terrible criminal Barabbas, all because he was afraid of public opinion. My poor dear Pilate, I tried to warn you. I told you about my dream and that the accusations against him were false, that there was something special about this man. Oh, my dear husband, you tried so hard to be strong, but yet you gave in. You gave in and now I'm so afraid. Afraid of the consequences, now that you've turned him over to the crowd to be crucified.
Let's go!